First, make sure Premiere has enough time to generate your audio waveforms. When assembling a sequence, you can watch the progress in the top right corner of the application. If the waveforms have had their chance to load, we can also check the settings in the timeline panel. Open the wrench icon to enable Show Audio Waveform. After that, use the toolbar at the top to go to Window, Workspace. Reset to save layout. If those steps didn't fix the display issue, let's check your preferences. On a Mac, the Preferences menu can be found by selecting Premiere Pro, Settings. On a PC, open the Edit menu, then select Preferences. In the Audio Preferences, enable Generate Waveforms Automatically. Press OK. If that doesn't work, go to the Media Cache Preferences, enable Save CFA and Peak Media Cache Files next to Original Media Cache Files when possible. Select OK. If you still don't see your files, let's clear the media cache completely and reset your preferences. Close Premiere Pro. Give it a minute to close completely. Hold Shift on your keyboard, then relaunch the app. Keep holding Shift until the reset options appear. Tell Premiere to reset app preferences and clear media cache files. Because you reset your preferences, the home screen will be blank. Select Open Project to pick up where you left off. As a last resort, let's render and replace your audio files. Disable linked selection in the timeline. Right-click your audio file and select Render and Replace to see the waveforms appear. This is a last resort because it creates extra files and takes up a small amount of extra storage space on your hard drive. We hope this helped.